time to move on to our third speaker, who is Lennart Johansson, who's a business developer on maritime technology at Blue Science Park. So we'll see if we can hand over to Lennart.
Thank you for that, Daniel. Lennart Johansson, a business developer within the maritime technology at Blue Science Park here in Karlskrona. And the Blue Science Park, it's an innovation hub working with maritime technology, of course, and even very deep into every aspect of digitalization happens all over the world. We are member-owned, and we have around 80-plus members. So, and we have the members are from every kind of organization within the society. So we have connection to all levels we need to connect to. And the aim for my presentation is to reach out to you. We're looking to connect with you, just you and your organization. The focus areas we have within the maritime technology, we are working, of course, very broadly over the maritime technology area, but we have a focus area of these three. It's the defense. You have heard of naval base and so on. So, of course, we are very strong in that. We have the offshore, also talking about that before, and we have the sustainable ocean, which is a very important question for the future of for all of us. If we're looking into these three different pictures, you can see on the right side, it's a design of a submarine made by Saab Kockums. As you already heard, we have 340 years of experience in maritime technology. So we are really start to learn how to do it. The picture also shown with wind parks. We have a very strong companies in that area, for example, Anchor Team Rockstech, as mentioned before, and also Ocean Harvesting Technology, which is a small company, a small startup, which hopefully very soon will release their products for energy in the ocean. And we also have a sustainable ocean, and in that area we want to we are a city out in the archipelago, so the water and the status of water is very important for us, so we want to connect, very easy to say, but connect the ocean and collect data, and by that building facts and building knowledge in the long sense. We are a complete local ecosystem. In a small area, we have a complete local ecosystem, which means that we are very easy to connect to us, and we are very fast moving. And as you can see in this slide, we have a BTH with research education. We have a governmental organizations, Regan and municipalities. We have the designers and producers. Here is just mentioning a few of them. And we also have the end users with the Navy, staying aligned and so on. So we can very easy reach out to every kind of organization in this structure. That is a very strength for us to get input for every kind of work we are doing. As explained, Maritime Hub, Maritime Innovation Hub, you can compare us, you can see us as the Maritime Silicon Valley. We have everything in place. We have an established innovation network. We have a test bed. As mentioned before, just outside BTH, we have an underwater technology test bed that is with an ROV, so we can very easy go out and make some tests. We have networks of experts in place. We have access to BTH with student resources. And we have lots of events and conferences just to meet out, learn to know each other, and spread the knowledge in the local area. So the Maritime Silicon Valley here in Blekinge. So as I started, we're looking to connect. We want to connect you, your organization, your team. We want to connect to all to discuss the challenges, the missions we have ahead of us in regards to maritime technology. So don't hesitate to it. You can take next. Here you have the contact details to me and to my colleague David Appelberg at Blue Science Park. So don't hesitate. Just send us a mail or give us a call, and we take a discussion from there. Okay, thank you for me.
Thank you very much, Lennart. I was wondering, could you explain a little bit more about the Maritime Living Lab idea that you're working on?
Yeah, for sure. EU has produced a document called Mission Starfish 2030, and that document describes how we should take care of our water in every kind of aspect, as fresh water, seawater, ocean water, and so on. And that document states that we don't have enough facts about the status of our water, what happens over time. So due to that, we don't have knowledge, and we don't have knowledge, we don't write the policies. If we don't have the policies, we don't do the investments in research and development at companies. So it's a very, the chain is not good, so to say. We want to do with the Maritime Living Lab is to connect the ocean, collect data. So we start with gathering data, gathering facts. By the facts, we building knowledge, and by the knowledge, we can write policy and take control of it, and we can give important data to researchers, companies, entrepreneurs who want to take care of water. So the main goal for that Maritime Living Lab is building knowledge, and by that, taking action and take care of our water in every aspect.
And how far have you come in developing that idea or executing
it? We are, let's say, in a planning phase. We are searching for partners in this work, and we are collecting money to take the first step this year, and hopefully have it in place in the coming years. Not so far away, hopefully. But we are very eager in this phase to connect to people that have any kind of inputs or ideas, or who want to cooperate with us in this question to build the Maritime Living Lab. And we think it's very exciting. It's very exciting.
Great. Thank you very much, Lennart.